Let's have a look how Amazon-style coding interviews work. We will explore what are the format of such interviews, what are the specifics of Amazon interviews, and what would be the strategy to approach coding challenges. So let's start with the format. Such coding challenges I usually consist of simple to medium complexity lead code style challenges. So for example, if you're practicing on lead code, I would suggest practicing using either simple or medium complexity challenges there. You will not be able to use any integrated development environment. Instead, you will be provided with what I call a whiteboard emulation. With the code you will be writing, you'll have some highlighting, but there will be no code suggestion or anything like that. And you will have around 20 minutes to solve the challenge. What are the specifics of the Amazon-style coding interviews? You can use any programming language you know, unless they specifically ask you to use a particular programming language. Whenever in doubt, you can always double-check and ask the interviewer if they're okay with you using a particular programming language, but as a rule of thumb, any language should be fine. You will be assessed on multiple layers. For example, the interviewers might assess speed, correctness of your code, attention to details that you show during the interview, your knowledge of the algorithms and data structures, the quality of your code that you are producing, your attitude to a known problem. So, for example, how will you react in case you don't know how to solve the challenge and you feel the time pressure? It happens quite often at workplace. You will also be expected to do something, or at least to say something, what you're going to do about errors or invalid input. The other thing to remember is that the challenges may have layers of complexity. So don't feel overconfident if you can solve the original challenge fast, because sometimes it's just the first part of the challenge. But sometimes it's not the case and challenge will have no layers whatsoever. So what would be a strategy to approach such coding challenges? I will be describing the strategy that worked personally for me. It might not necessarily be the best strategy, but at least the strategy proved to be working. Don't rush into solving the challenge, because the last thing you want to end up with is when you are happy that you solved the challenge, but you solved the wrong one. Always validate your assumptions and ask for unusual and awkward values. Don't assume that, for example, only positive values for a Fibonacci sequence will be accepted. No assumptions. Ask. A very important skill is to think aloud. I would even recommend you practicing this before the interview. Make sure that the interviewer knows where you're going to and where you're going from. If you feel stuck, if you don't see a better way to solve the challenge fast, start with the brute force approach. You can always optimize later. Do not panic if you feel lost, and instead listen to what the interviewers might be saying. Interviewers are actually very interested in you succeeding, so there are very good chances that they will offer you some helpful tip or advice. On the other hand, if you think that you're onto something and interviewers is being overly helpful, try not to let interviewer to interfere with your chain of thought. And finally, use test-driven development. Obviously, you cannot write a unit test and you cannot rely on unit testing framework or IDE or compiler, but you can and probably should come up with some testing scenarios which you would be validating with your interviewers, and then you can validate your code against those testing scenarios. I hope that this video was helpful. In the next video, I will be solving a very simple coding challenge, FizzBuzz, demonstrating an approach you might take if it was an actual coding interview.